Hey everyone, and I hope you're doing well. Welcome to a long overdue video dedicated to all of you comic book fans out there, whether you have collected in the past or currently still do. I have a bunch, about a two dozen or so, loose comic books that I plan to bag and board, basically taking a comic book backing board that helps keep them sturdy while in storage, and then sliding them into this bag. I figured this would make some nice sounds. And I have been meaning to do another comic book video like this, especially for all of you comic book fans out there. This has been something I have been meaning to do for probably about 2 years now. But what happened is I stopped collecting comic books probably about 2 or 3 years now. The same time since it's probably since the last time I did a comic book video. So before we get any further, I would love to hear from you if you currently collect, what you might be reading, if you're a Marvel or a DC or any other kind of publishing company fan, you know, Dark Horse, whatever it might be. Or, you know, if you no longer, you know, read, but you once did, still love to hear what some of your favorite comic books were. One of the reasons that I stopped collecting wasn't just, I guess it was a mix of obsessive behavior and financial, because honestly, you know, I love art. I love all kinds of music, movies, films, comedians, and books and comic books. And I could honestly, if I had the money and the time, buy every single issue of a comic book out there. I love the different art styles, the different, you know, characters and such. And time was another issue why I had to stop collecting comics. There's only so much time between working, making videos, family, and what spare time I have left, me time. Usually I watch a movie and I try to read. I don't quite read as often as I should, but okay. So this is a backing board, and this is a protective plastic sleeve, I guess you would say. And this isn't any particular brand. There are certain backing boards that not only help keep the comic book sturdy while in the bag and in storage, but certain backing boards have a certain are made a certain way with a certain material to help, I think, prevent the backing board from, or the back of the comic book. It helps with acid. They might be acid-free or something like that. I don't know. I've never purchased any of those premium backing boards. So that's the first step, is just putting the backing board in the little plastic sleeve like this. And then you just take your comic book, you just slide it down right in the front like that, and then you can just tape it closed. I'm not going to do that, it's going to be too noisy. Or you can just quick and dirty way, just kind of fold the sleeve in like that. It's making a little bit too much noise. I'm not sure if I'll fold it in during the video. I may just slide the comic book in there. So I thought I would also just talk about the comic books and then show you a little bit of the artwork. So this is The Calling, Cthulhu Chronicles. It is by Boom Studios. I'm not sure if they are a completely independent company or if they are owned by DC or Marvel. I'm not really hip to all the comic book industry these days. But if I can show you something here that might be kind of Cthulhu worthy. The artwork in here isn't really, here you go, here's a little something there. I can't even recall what the story was about. Hopefully it was a good one. Oh yeah, actually you would actually slide the comic book like this and then tuck the flap in the back. Just no right way or wrong way of doing this. So there we go. So I'm just gonna do that throughout the video and talk a little bit about the comic books. Oh yeah, and one other thing that I'm not sure if I forgot to ask this in the beginning. How is the comic book industry doing these days? Is it still thriving? Is it, last time I looked, there were in the last comic book store that I went, there were a ton of titles. I don't know how you go in there and choose. This is Batman Beyond. Here's a little a peek at the artwork. And Batman Beyond is the story of future Batman, that Bruce Wayne is retired and he is training a successor. Why is this? There we go. I'm considering picking up a couple comic books. The problem is, it's hard to just pick up an issue, especially if it's in the middle of a storyline or plotline. But might be kind of cool to do that, just to do a pickup, a comic book pickup video. I don't think it'd be too bad to pick up four titles, something like that, and kind of just talk about them. This is Chew. This is a funny book. This is based on a character, a detective, that has visions of what happened to the victims he eats. Either he eats what they ate, or he eats a part of them. So it's a little macabre. It's kind of, I think it's done now. I don't think it's still in publication. But here's a little glimpse of the artwork. Nice stylized kind of I'm not really good when it comes to explaining the types of art designs, artistic designs, stylized, blocky, I don't really know what you would call them. The different, I guess the ink or coloring styles. Yeah, I've never really, not my thing really. I got into comic books as a young Catholic schoolboy. And I just say that because I went to Catholic school, but when I got into comics, I was about 16, something like that. And the story goes, there was a kid, new kid, that you might have heard this before. There was a new kid started in school, seventh grade. And I gave him a hard time. I forget how it happened, but I went up to him and I pushed him in his desk. I pushed him from behind or something like this. Because I was getting picked on a lot up to that point. I was name called. So I thought it was, I would do this thing and it would be funny and all that. But then we became best friends. And I don't know what happened between when I pushed him and us becoming the best of friends. I don't know. I think I apologized at one point. I honestly don't remember. But from seventh grade all the way up through high school, and then me leaving town, we were the best of friends, and he introduced me to comic books. And I was just blown away. I didn't know anything about comic books before him. So every Saturday, we would go to the comic book store, ride our bikes. And it was probably a good, I'm not really good with miles, but it was, a good 20-minute bike ride on our 10-speed bikes, I think. I don't think I'm going to, I don't know if I'm going to put these in, fold these back. It's making a lot of sharp, crinkly sounds I'm going to have to edit out. Severed by Scott Snyder. Scott Snyder, a really good writer. I'm not sure if he's still writing for comic books. I unfortunately did not collect this entire series. Scott Snyder has written for quite a few titles for DC. I'm not sure if he's done any Marvel work or not. But being introduced to comic books when I was 15 or 16, it was this completely new medium. To me, it was unlike anything I've ever seen. I just don't, remember before then being introduced, and it was just, I loved it. I fell in love. And comic books were a huge inspiration. I'm not really sure how much comic books. I didn't show you any of the artwork of Severed. Sorry about that. Here's DC's Blackest Night. This is when this death, I guess that's who's pictured here, but basically a bunch of DC, I think, was in the process of reviving and bringing back some old characters that were killed off and whatnot. I think in this series they killed Batman. No, Batman actually was killed before this, when this took place. Here's Death. He's a Black Lantern, something like that. So they brought like Aquaman back. He was a Black Lantern and all this. It was 8 series, Blackest Night, and then Brightest Day. So, and the comic book DC and Marvel, they're kind of known for doing that. But the artwork, I like the artwork, and the storyline was cool. And I stopped reading comic books when I was about, when I left home. I was about 18 or 19. I think I stopped reading. Something like that. And then I got back into them just around 2008, 2009. Something like that. And back in the 80s, there was this stigma that comic books were evil, were violent, and all this stuff. You know, it's there's so many stigmas, especially like with language, you know. You know, bad words, foul language, and all this. You know, I don't want to get into a whole thing, but you know, drawing and writing, you know, it's a great way to make a living. You know, everyone has their passion. I mean, that's the world we live in. I don't want to get into all that. What am I doing? Let's just anyway. Here's Wolverine by I think it's Jason Aaron is the writer. Yeah, Jason Aaron. He's another good writer. This was April 2012. Let's see if I can find. Here's a good little. Right there. I'm not a diehard Wolverine fan. I like Wolverine. I think one of the reasons I don't like Wolverine as much is because, you know, I don't know what it is exactly. I can tell you why I like Batman, because Batman has a whole cast of villains. Wolverine doesn't seem to have that. It's just a guy with his claws, and I don't know. It's something that doesn't completely fascinate me about him. You know, it seems like he's very one-dimensional. Maybe that's what it is. I don't know. Maybe it's just me. I'm not dissing on the character. I just, you know, I don't know what it is. I like Wolverine. You know, a lot, you know, but maybe it's because Batman is so ingrained in, you know, TV, and it's like I don't know. I'm trying to analyze. I don't want to analyze all that. Nah, this is Captain America. It's bent a little bit by Brubaker. He's the writer. There's usually the writer, the penciler, and the colorist. Let's see. Ed Brubaker. Pretty good writer. which is one of the reasons I got back into comic books. I decided to venture into, you know, some different titles like Captain America and all that. I'm not really going to read anything. It's really hard to just... It's not like reading an excerpt from a book. You can read one page and you don't even know what the heck's going on, but... this one had Red Skull in it. I don't remember this storyline, but here's a Red Skull right there. Get this one in the bag. So let me know if you would like to see me pick up some titles. I could do that. I don't want to pick up, you know, I don't want to spend like $100 on comic books. Really, because I'm not going to read them. I'm not going to have time. And I don't want to acquire things just to acquire things. I have a bad habit of doing that. But let me know some titles that are currently out that I might be able to pick up off the shelf. And maybe in a month or so, I can do a comic book pickup video. I could read about it, I guess. I mean, and kind of do a review, or, you know, like I do with the movies and what have you, like I do with the beer videos that I don't do anymore. I have a lot of comics to bag and board, though, so I can definitely do a lot more of these. Superman, written by Straczynski. A lot of people don't like Straczynski, or at least I'm not sure if he's still writing. This was a one-off title. This is when Superman was kind of rebooted. They do that. This is Superman just flying around town and helping regular people. I don't like the type of this artwork. It's not appealing to me. There was a point in time back in, was this 2012 maybe, when Straczynski was writing for quite a few titles and relaunching them. DC was, around that time, was not really reinventing, but retelling. I don't know if they were retelling the tales either. No, they weren't doing that. They weren't starting over. They were just kind of, I forget. It's been a while. You'll have to forgive me. Secret Six. This is, if I'm not mistaken, a bunch of villains brought together. Work for the government. I don't really forget. But Gail Simone. I don't know how many female writers there are, but it was cool to have a female writer. And she writes well. She's a good writer. And I enjoyed her writing in this. I know you probably think comic books and good writing. But that's what the industry has done, from what I've been told. Is that they've... since around 2012 or so, after, you know, DC and Marvel, they kind of went in the tank. Again... from what I understand, because I was out of the comic book world for decade at least. DC Marvel just kind of tanked in the mid-90s or early 2000s. I'm not sure if they ever fully recovered. But they hired a bunch of writers, especially some who written books, to help write, kind of revitalize, I guess, some of their titles. Gail Simone, I'm not really sure what her experience is, but I think she's a good writer. This is Red Robin. Why is he called Red Robin? I don't know. I can't remember now. But I enjoyed this title. Here's a sample of the artwork. It's nice and colorful and vibrant, and I like the pencil style to it. Chris Yost is the writer. Then you always have the penciler and the colorist, the colorer. I'm not sure which the right way of saying that. So yeah, Red Robin. I'm not sure if Red Robin is still around. Thor, this isn't any particular issue. Straczynski, again. And I can't for the life of me remember what Straczynski was doing with Thor. But he was making his rounds in DC and Marvel. Here's a sample of the artwork for this title. And the titles, they always change, in case you don't know. They always change writers, pencilers. I'm not really sure how it works, if they rotate from title to title. But that. Some of my favorite comic book memories were the old Justice League with Batman and Green Lantern, not Hal Jordan, Guy Gardner. I can't remember everyone in that Justice League. That's when the Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles first came out. Probably should have grabbed that title because it turned into a movie and it kind of exploded. There was the Question. I liked him. I liked finding some of the obscure titles a little bit, kind of like with my music. When I got into heavy metal, I was obsessed with heavy metal. And I remember going down to Tower Records on South Street in Philadelphia, looking for every kind of metal band in existence. This is Thunderbolts. This is another one of these titles where they have a bunch of villains brought together to do the bidding of a secret organization, from what I understand. Ghost, Moonstone, Juggernaut, Man-Thing, Satana, Shocker, Boomerang, Troll, Mr. Hyde, Songbird. Their base is a Supermax prison facility known as the Raft. A handpicked team of inmates had the chance to go outside prison, blah, 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 to deal with the worst of the world. Yeah, so it's, I'm not sure if they're still around, but here's Juggernaut. For some reason, he's got some kind of powered suit. I think he gets hit by lightning or something. I don't really know. I can't remember. And I was always a wannabe artist. For whatever reason, I just could never find that one thing that I was good at. Writing, drawing. I don't know if it's how my brain is wired. I just don't know if it's because I don't have the patience. Back then, that's his venom. But comic books inspired me. I used to start to draw own little comics just for fun. Venom. Venom's okay. I never really, I'm kind of a fan of Venom, I guess. Kind of cool character. It's basically this alien life force thing that takes over a certain person and can change shape and all this. It's some kind of substance. And as of the date of this video, the movie Logan is out in the theaters, and I want to see that, kinda. But there's also a couple other movies out I want to see, like Get Out. And I can't see every movie, I don't have the time to. Plus there's some movies that we want to see as a family, but this is X-Men. But if you've seen Logan, love to hear if you've seen that movie and what you think about it. So this is X-Men, and I forget. I kind of like the artwork here. The penciler kind of draws them very chunky, blocky, kind of very caricature. Style, which I think is okay. I don't have too much of a problem with it. But, what choice do I have? But everybody has their own tastes, This is Daredevil, and The Man Without Fear, and I think this is after Daredevil went rogue. There was a point around 2012 when Daredevil went rogue and basically became a bad guy, became a villain. So here's some of the artwork from this one. I don't really remember this particular title. Sometimes the title, I mean this particular issue and what the story was. Sometimes the issues are one-off stories. Sometimes they're a little mini-series. Four issues of a particular storyline. Sometimes they're really major. Storyline. And sometimes the comic book companies are, it's not always about what the writers want to write, I don't think. I think sometimes it's a lot about what the comic book companies want to do with a title, and then they dictate to the writers what they want, I think. I don't know the ins and outs of the comic book industry. But sometimes I think you can read between the lines and know that they're trying to promote a title and do something to, you know, to gain attention, like killing off a character. This is The Man of Steel. This was, from what I understand, the retelling of the tale of Superman. I think it gave, and I think this is what the 1980s movies with Christopher Reeve, were based on. So here is the old classic comic book look from back in the day when they didn't have the glossy kind of paper that they seem to use today. Superman's okay. I'm not a huge fan of soups. I guess I'm wearing a Batman shirt because I threw out, no, donated. I think that's what we usually do, donate to the Goodwill. Although sometimes we throw them out, but we try to donate. A lot of my comic book t-shirts. So sorry, Marvel fans, that I'm wearing a Batman t-shirt. I just threw one on just for the sake of it. It's the last one that I have. I don't know why I just kept this one. Anyway, Silver Surfer. Kind of a cool, interesting character. He's very, how you would put it, not quiet and reserved, like shy. Just never seems to talk a lot. And I even forget what powers he has. But basically, I'm going to assume that you know who Galactus is. He serves Galactus. He's supposed to, I forget what they're called, but Silver Surfer and a few others, they go around finding planets for Galactus to feed on. He's the world devourer. He's a giant humanoid. There's a Spider-Man, The Grim Hunt. This was a good storyline. I enjoyed it. Basically, Spider-Man was being hunted by Kraven the Hunter. See if I can find a good little page here. Might show you some of the. Yeah, here we go. I guess this is kind of good enough. Well, it's kind of dark, but is there anything a little bit lighter? Well. Here we go. Spider-Man and Spider-Woman, or Spider-Girl, I don't know, fighting Kraven. Well, no, it's not Kraven, it's somebody else, actually. So, there was actually a good storyline of Spider-Man fighting all of his villains. Rhino, Killer Croc. I like the storyline to that. And I think that was around the same time when the Spider-Man movies were coming out. I'm not mistaken. So, and the comic books these days are about $4, almost $5 a pop. And we're getting down the end here. Finish up with two more. I don't want to go a whole hour here. Now, I kind of feel a little bit for any of the writers out there and the artists who love to write love to draw end up getting a job where they can do just that and maybe end up where it becomes a job and they kind of lose that passion a little bit, where they're told to write or draw a certain way, and you can't demand creativity from an artist sometimes, unless it becomes a daily routine. Which is a reason why I don't do role play video after role play video after. You can't always just create. A lot of people need inspiration, which is why I do different videos here on my channel. And that's just one of the reasons. I also, I don't want to get into the whole thing of why I do videos. That's not the point why we're here. BPRD. This is Dark Horse comic based off of, it's a spinoff from Hellboy, the Bureau of Paranormal Research and Development, which actually sounds like a good idea for a role play. I really should tap into some of these themes here. I could probably do something with this. They always seem to have a different, Mike Mignola is always the writer, but they always seem to have a different, well, I know he's the owner of the franchise, I believe. I'm not sure if he still writes every issue. There's four people listed here, but, there's always a different, penciler, I think, and a colorist. There I go with that colorist word. I don't even know if that's the right word. For the person that does the coloring. But that's what I'm calling them. So. And then another single issue of Hellboy, The Storm. I really gotta pick up. I love Hellboy. I really do. I don't know why I've stopped collecting Hellboy. Let's see if I can find a nice little. Here we go. I've always loved the artwork of the Hellboy series. I'm not sure if it's still going on. I don't know how long people can continue to write stories for some of these franchises or titles without just bringing them to an end. But maybe that's what different writers are for, you know, to bring in new, fresh ideas. I don't know how writers do it sometimes. Especially people who write actual books and series of books and just can continue to just go and go and go. All right. So. As you can see. Here we have all of the individual comics all bagged and boarded. And I'm just going to, I might tape them up, not really sure. What they look like once you're all done, and then you just get a box like this, corrugated cardboard box. And you just put them in here, stand them straight up, stack them. Alright, well, thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed. For those of you who have been long-time subscribers that have been waiting for a video like this, I hope it served you well, meets up to your expectations, and you know, whether you're a long time subscriber or new, and if you collect comic books, like I said, let me know if you'd like to see another. And yeah, like I said, I'll try to pick up some new titles. Yeah, I'll give it some good, give it a thought. All right, thanks as always for watching, and I wish you all my best until next time. Take care. Bye-bye.